Good morning students, welcome back. In previous class we are discussed the concept of iteration. In iteration there are two types. One is definite loop, second one is indefinite loop. And the construction of a loop classified into two types. They are entry control loop and exit control loop. These are we have discussed in previous class, but in today's class we are discussed while loop, do while loop and for loop thoroughly. First we have to discuss the while loop. The while loop in Java. The while loop is a fundamental looping statement. It is a fundamental looping statement. And it repeats a set of instruction or a block of statements while the expression that control if it is true. It means only while loop is executed when the block of statement with the expression that control it is true. Then only the while loop can be executed. It means it repeats a statement or a block of statement while the expression that control it is a true, then only the while loop will be executed. And the general form of the while statement is while condition. We have to check the condition in a bracket, opening braces and closing braces for the while. Here body of the loop, this is the syntax, this is the syntax of the while statement or a loop. Here the condition can be any boolean expression. It may be only boolean expression are two. One is true, another one is false. The body of the loop execute as long as condition is true. Only while loop can execute if the condition is true. When the condition become a false, the control passes to the line of the code immediate to the following loop. It means the condition only check whether the condition or a expression is true. Otherwise, if the expression is false, the lines of code can be passes to the following loop immediately. Now we can see example for the while loop. First we can create a class. Class name is demo. In this we have to write a main method, that is public static void main. In this I am going to pass a string as, this is used for passing the argument in the command from. Here in main method, first we have to initialize in I value, I equal to 1. While here I am going to write a condition, that is I is less than or equal to 10. In while loop, system dot out dot println, I am going to print a I values. And next is incrementation of the loop. Closing while loop, main method and class. Output for this program is, we can trace this program. First here this is initialization of the variable, this is incrementation. If the condition is true, then the value going to be print and incremented. Now we see here I value is 1, it means here 1 is assigned, that is 1 is less than or equal to 10. The condition is true, then it comes to print a 1 in a terminal. Next, here 1 is printed here and this value is incremented with a 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 is less than equal to 10. The condition is true, then it going to print a 2 values here. Then again incrementation. 2 is 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Again 3 is less than equal to 10. Then condition is true, then again I value going to be print here. Here the execution of the program goes on same up to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, here 10. 10 is less than or equal to 10. Again the I value going to be print as 10. 10 is incremented with 1, that is 11. 11 is less than or equal to 10. The condition may going to be false. The condition is, or a loop will terminated and executed the come out of loop. The while loop only executed when the value is true. Other than the control passes the code to the next line. This is your while loop program. I hope you all are understand. Next, we can learn do while concept. Next concept is do while. In this concept, the do while loop is, as you seen in the while loop, if the condition expression is false, the body of loop will not executed even the once. If the while loop only execute when the expression is true. If expression is false, the body of loop is not executed at least once. Sometimes it may require to that body of loop can be executed in our program. Because of that problem, Java provide the do while loop concept to test the condition at the end of the loop. Here, at the end of the loop, the condition can be tested rather than the beginning. Here, test condition is evaluated at the end of the loop rather than the beginning of the loop. This is the special feature of do while loop. Here we can see the do while loop syntax. Do with the opening brace, closing brace, here while condition. Here in middle body of the loop. This is the syntax of do while loop. Now we can see one example. You can easily know the concept of do while loop according to this program. First, we can create a class, that is class name is demo. Next, main method public static void main. In this string x, in this main method I have to initialize I value, that is 10. I can use this syntax here to the body of the loop is I am going to print a values system.out.println. The number is 10. I am going to pass a I value. Here I equal to I plus 1. The do loop is closed. Again here I am going to check the condition while n is less than or equal to 10. Again in output line I am going to print a this is end. Closing brace for the main, closing brace for the class. Here the output is first here the do loop will be executed. Here the first it is printed the this statement, the number is 10. The number is 10. Again the condition will be checked while n or a I is less than or equal to 10. I value is 10. 10 is less than 10. The condition becomes false So the loop will terminated and it's come out of the loop and printed this statement. This is a n. The while loop, while condition is false. Because of that, the loop will come out of the condition is come out of the loop and printed. This is the end. This is the simple example of do while loop. In while loop, condition, if the condition is true, then only expression is or a condition is evaluated. But here, if the condition is false, then also the it executed at the end of the do loop with the while. Here we have to check the condition. This is the simple example of do while loop. Next, we have to move with for loop. For loop in Java. In a for loop, a program may be executed or a program may require to perform a repeated tasks. It may be in for loop, program may require to perform a repetitive task such as printing a 20 times or adding a some numbers, etc. It means printing a 20 times means same word or a same statement can printed in a 20 time. To print that 20 times, we need to use the for loop in our program. And for loop can make a task very easier with the condition. And also the for loop should be used for a loops which have a predetermined number of iteration. Here in for loop, predetermined numbers of iterations are allows. And also for loop include predetermined number of iteration. If how many times we execute the loop, that are going to print in our program with the predefined number of iteration. And also while and do while loops should be used when the number of iteration is not known before. In previous concept, predetermined numbers of iteration are not used, but here in this for loop we are using predetermined number of iterations. And for loop perform followings. For loop can perform followings. What are all the for loop can perform the task? We can see one by one. First one is set the initial value. In for loop, that perform first task is set the initial value. Second one is perform a test to see the whether the loop should continue. it perform a test to whether the loop should continue or loop should end the task. Third one is executing a loop actions. First is set the initial value. Second one is perform a test to see the whether the loop should continue or not. Third one is executing the loop action. And fourth one is update the values of used for the test. Update the values used for the test. These are the four following steps performed by the for loop. Now we can see the syntax of the for loop. First is for. For is a keyword in that initialization condition, again iteration, opening braces and closing braces. Here is a body of loop. This is the syntax of for loop. For loop. Now we can see one example of the for loop. Example for the for loop. First, same class, in class main method, that is public static void main. Again in this I'm going to pass string args. In this first I am going to initialize I value I equal to 0. Then for loop, for I equal to here only I initialize I value, sorry, here only we declare a I, here we initialize a value I equal to 0, I is less than or equal to 10, then I plus plus. Here see, for loop, this is the initialization, this is the iteration. We can, in this, in for loop, I am going to print some lines with the output line, that is system.out.println. In this, this is a line with here I am going to pass a I value with the plus symbol. It is used to, plus symbol is used to concatenate the two statements. In again in system.out.println, this is the output line. I am going to print this is the end. Here I am going to close the main method and also class. Now we can check the output of this program. First one is the for loop will execute I equal to 0. I is initialized to 0. 0 is less than or equal to 10. The condition may true. Again this line will be printed. This is a line with the I value is printed, that is 1. Next, the value going to be incremented with the 1, that is 2. 0 plus 1 is 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 is less than or equal to 2. Again, this line is executed. This is a line with a incrementation, that is 2. Again, same, this line is executed. 2 is less than or equal to 10. Condition is true. This line is printed. Again, the incremented will happens, that is 3. It is goes on until the 10th times. This is the value of 10. This is how for loop can be performed. First, the check the condition. If the value is true, this line will be executed with the increment of 1, that is I value, that is 1. This flow will continue up to I value is 11. If the 11 is less than or equal to 10, the condition become false, then the for loop will turn off, then printed the, this is the AND. This is the AND. This is how for loop will be executed in our program. I hope you all are understand. In today's class, we discussed while loop, while loop. Second one is do while loop. Again, for loop. And also example for of each loops. In next class, we have to see some programs on each loop or a all loops involved in a one program, that can be discussed in next class. Thank you.